Yes, this is a very, very beautiful chapter, second chapter, the 10th canto. It's a very good chapter to study before we enter into Janmashtami time period. As you see in the picture here, this is Mother Devaki sitting, and all the devatas are coming to worship the Lord in the womb. One thing becomes very evident when you see this picture. Although Lord is in the womb, still the devatas know that he is always in a liberated situation. Because if any living entity would be in the womb of any mother, you know, it is considered an entangled living entity, subjected to bondage. Because being in the womb of a mother is one of the fourfold real problems of life. You know, janma, mrityu, jara, vyadhi, dukkha, dosha, anudarshanam. You know, like that Krishna says. Whereas for Krishna, you know, none of it can bind him. Neither is he bound in the womb like a, you know, baby to be born. Nor does he get old, nor does he get any type of diseases, nor does he die. His so-called death is like the appearing of the sun and disappearing of the sun from our sight. The Prabhupada gave an example when he was in New York. He was giving a class. You know, there were some fast-moving cars outside, and they were going very fast and making noise also. So whenever a car would go, after every few minutes, the devotees would just turn around and see what is the noise. So Prabhupada saw that they are getting distracted, but he used that distraction as a means to teach them philosophy. He said, okay, now you all turned around and saw the passing car. You didn't see the car. You didn't see the car before. Now you see the, you saw the car now. Again, you didn't see the car. This is how Krishna appears and disappears. Like the Prabhupada said. You know, Krishna manifests in front of our eyes visibly, and then he becomes unmanifest, invisible. That doesn't mean he doesn't exist. He exists in another universe, another place, where he continues manifesting his pastimes. So his appearance and disappearance is like the appearance of the sun and disappearance of the sun from our sight. One most amazing thing with the sun is, you know, when it becomes night for us, we say that, wake up with the sun, sleep with the sun, we say. But the sun doesn't wake up, we wake up actually. Because the sun is always woken up only. Either sun is giving light to India or it is giving light in America there. You know, it is going all around the globe. There is no resting time for the sun. Whereas the resting time is only for the jivas. Sun is always awake. So therefore it is said in the Bhagavatam, Chakshur Yasya Narishyati. The Supreme Lord, he never blinks his eyes. We have to blink our eyes every now and then for protecting the eyes with the eyelids. But the Lord's eye never blinks, it is said. Similarly, because even the devatas, they are called as Naimishe. Animesha Kshetre, we say, no? Animesha means actually, Animesh means devatas. Animesh means devatas also don't blink. Their eyes also don't blink. Like the way we blink our eyes, they also don't. If devatas can avoid blinking, naturally Supreme Lord can completely avoid blinking. One thing becomes clear when you go from earthly platform to heavenly platform, there are many upgradations. Like the devatas, they don't touch the ground with their feet. They can actually chant a mantra, disappear in one place, disappear in another place. They can invisibly appear also. Like here you find them. Somebody coming in this room can sense that somebody else is here in the room. But you will not know who is in the room very clearly. That kind of appearance devatas can make. Therefore, in America, when Prabhupada was in one place, when they were arranging a program, they arranged a big program. But only 7 people turned up. So devotees were very disappointed. So when devotees told Prabhupada at the end of the program, "We are sorry, Prabhupada, we couldn't get anybody for you. We expected some 1,000 people." Prabhupada said, "Don't worry, there were more than 1,000 people. They were all demigods and sages like Narada, everybody occupying the whole hall. You didn't see it, but I saw them," Prabhupada said. So it was not a psychological satisfaction or some imagination, it is actually a reality. Wherever you glorify the Supreme Lord. Wherever heartfelt prayers are offered, wherever the pastimes and the names of the Lord are chanted and sung, in that place immediately there are always devatas also and great devotees present there. Because they can be easily present there, because when they become pure devotees, and they transcend the material barriers also, then they can actually come to any place where the prayer goes on. And such type of presence of the devatas is like, there is one verse of Hanuman. Yatra yatra raghunatha kirtanam tatra tatra kritamastakanjalim bashpavari paripurna lochanam marutim namatah rakshasantakam. There's a verse. This verse says, wherever, whichever place, Raghunatha Kirtanam means singing of Lord Rama's names happens. Tatra tatra kritamastakanjali. He's saying, in that place, Hanuman comes and bows down his head. He says, and Bashpavari Paripurna Lochana means eyes become flooded with Prema Bashpa, which means the tears of Premashru. Marutim Namataha Rakshasantam. I bow down to that Maruti Lord Hanuman, it is said. So, just as Hanuman is coming and bowing down to a place where Lord's songs are being sung, similarly here also, Lord is personally present in the womb of Devaki, and all the devatas are coming. In Acharya's explanations, they say Lord is not present in the womb of Devaki exactly. Lord was transported from the mind of Vasudev to the heart of Devaki. So the garbha that is being spoken is actually Hridaya Garbham, and the heart of Devaki. So Srila Prabhupada, if you read the book Spiritual Master and Disciple, there they have given quotes from Prabhupada, where it says that Spiritual Master and Disciple are compared to Vasudev and Devaki. Devaki is the disciple, Vasudev is the Spiritual Master. So the Spiritual Master is constantly remembering Krishna in his mind, and he is transferring Krishna to the heart of the disciple at the time of initiation. So as soon as Guru transfers Krishna into the heart of the disciple, faithful disciple, actually, as we say, you know, hit the rod when it is hot, as we say. Similarly, a disciple should take initiation from a guru when the disciple is at the peak of seriousness in spiritual life. And they are at the peak of inclination for going back to Godhead. And all the world becomes null and void. And one thinks that without chanting and without surrendering to guru, my life carries no sense. Like that, when one very strongly feels, at that time they are eligible to take initiation. And as soon as the disciple takes initiation, the guru gives Krishna in the heart of the disciple. So carrying Krishna in the heart, the disciple becomes extremely beautiful. He remembers guru, he remembers guru's instruction, he executes the duties like worshipping the deity, you know, cleaning the room and chanting the holy name, reading the scriptures, you know. And for the guru, for the disciple, these things become the heart of the disciple, and the material existence goes far, far away for such disciples, faithful disciples. So, in the same manner, just as such a disciple becomes very beautiful, it is said, to look at when he is faithfully engaged in Lord's service. In the same manner, when Devaki carries Krishna, she also becomes extremely beautiful. And that was noticed by Vasudev. That was noticed by even Kamsa also. Now Kamsa will come to see her, that my sister has become pregnant. She is going to give birth to the 8th child. And let us see Kamsa's meditation also. See, Kamsa is sitting here with all his crooked ministers. See, in the background of the picture, you see they are killing children. You are seeing that? Many, many children. They are very cruel fellows. And Rishamsaha, word is used, very ruthless fellows. Just because he want to save his life, you know, he's killing so many thousands of children everywhere. Kruka, very cruel fellow. So his ministers only gave him the idea, that why do you have to worry about your life? You know, you are bowing down to Devaki Vasudev, and just because you heard Durga Devi, Durga Mata, you know, speaking to you, don't worry, we are here with you. All devatas are afraid of you. So we will finish off all the children born in the recent past, and you can live a long life without any fear. So they are giving assurance. So this kind of unfortunate assurances are given by karmis, even to the devotees, especially I'm telling about devotee relatives. They will say that make a lot of money, you know, enjoy life. See, we are enjoying, you can enjoy like us. You know, life is not all that bad. You know, why are you doing bhajan? And this is not the age, you know. Even if you wish to do all this, when you are 80 plus, your body becomes good for nothing. You can always do that time. These are the kind of preachings of the non-devotees. And any genuine devotee will not fall for it. Rather, they will feel pity for them. So, Kamsa surrounded by yes men, these preachings look very nice for him. Because he has inflated false ego. He thinks, these are my well-wishers. Yeah. Because of this, all the Yadus fled to other kingdoms. You see, like Kurus, Panchalas, Kekayas and everything. Some stayed and served Kamsa. These are the two types of people. Like Akrura served Kamsa as a minister. But he was like a lotus in a pond, untouched by the mud. He remained a pure devotee. And because this, even many, many demons who were defeated by Kamsa, like Agasur, Bakasur, all those, Keshin, all of them. Either Kamsa defeated them, or Kamsa found them like an combat, equal combat. Then either he couldn't defeat them, they couldn't defeat him. And Kamsa put down the weapons and told them that, you know, say, since we both are equal, let us become friends. Now I will not kill you. I will keep you very well. Don't worry. I'll keep give you a nice place in my palace. I'll give you a nice position. I'll give you facilities for food, clothing, shelter, everything, salary, everything. You just be my friend. Let's stay, be happy together. Let us not kill each other. So Kamsa kept some demons like that. Some demons were subordinate to him. And some demons he killed. Some demons had to flee away for their lives, far away. So in this way, here you see, after the six sons of Devaki were killed, Lord Anantasesha entered her womb. So in the previous class, I told all of you how when Lord, when the six Anantas are removed, then Anantasesha comes to clean the platform for Lord Krishna to appear on the stage of the Devaki's womb. Just like you say, no? Devyat Prindaranya Kalpadrumada Srimad Ratnagara Simhasanastav Srimad Radha Shila Govinda Devav Preshtarivi Sevyamanav Smarami. So, the Ratnasan, Ratna Simhasan is made where Radha and Krishna are made to sit. You see, the Bhagavad Gita says, Ishvara Sarva Bhutanam Hriddeshe Arjuna Tishthati, it says. Tishtha means to stand. Why is Lord standing, Paramatma, in the heart of everybody? So one devotee was telling in the class yesterday here, he said, Paramatma is standing because your heart is not yet clean for him to sit. He said, when our heart is unclean, Paramatma is saying, how can I sit in this unclean place? But when pure devotee, his heart is purified, then we say, Tomara Hridaye Sada Govinda Vishram. We say, Vishram means he is lying down. Like he is lying in Anantashesh. And Lord Vishnu lies in Anantashesh because Anantashesh is the purest also. He is purest of the pure. So Lord lies on Anantashesh in the milk ocean. Similarly, here also when Ananta comes into the womb and he makes, after the six demons have created havoc and they have left the place, then you clean it. In our hearts, the demons create a havoc in our conditioned state. And then when the Kamsa Bhaya comes and the Devaki's life of leaving the child one by one, you know. So despite the fear of Kamsa killing the child, she is ready to beget a child. So and then hand over to Kamsa. In the same manner, the sadhana bhaktas also, you know, despite the their attachments will be finished in spiritual life. Like you have heard this saying, no? Yasyaham managruhnami harishyetad dhanam shanai. Krishna says, you know, which means if you hoard wealth, but with that wealth you try to become mischievous in not caring for spiritual life and becoming more and more materialistic, then Krishna says, I will take away that wealth, he says. Similarly, any attachments like kama, krodha, lobha, moha, mada, matsari, everything, Lord says that I will, although they are very dear to you in materialistic, I mean conditioned stage, I take them away. So these anarthas actually are bad for us, but still we are attracted to them. Just like a diabetes patient, it's not that he hates sweets, he still likes sweets. But doctor tells him that you cannot eat sweets. Similarly, these six impurities are still, like Devaki represents in the conditioned stage, sadhana bhakta. So still the attachment to the children is there, but she is ready to forego them, because only if she is ready to forego them, then only Krishna will appear. Similarly, only if we are ready to forego the six anarthas in our hearts also, Lord will appear. But prior to the Lord's appearance, Guru has to appear and cleanse our heart by giving Diksha. So at the time when Guru gives Diksha, he is actually representative of Ananta, Ananta Shesha. Like you see here, Ananta Shesha comes in our lives in the form of Guru. And then after cleansing the heart, he bestows Krishna. That's what Guru Krishna Prasade Pai Bhakti Lata Abhi. Brahmanda Brahmita Kona Bhagyavanaji. We say, we become Bhagyavanaji. So Ananta does his job and he goes to the womb of Rohini. Arranged by Krishna through the agency of Yogamaya. And then now the heart is fit for Krishna to appear. See, Yogamaya is called by Krishna and he tells her to transfer. How to do that, he says. Because generally you have heard of heart transfer, but nobody has done, you know, child transfer from one womb to another womb. If Matajis can do that, they will very comfortably transfer it to a servant maid or somebody and they can actually be free. But no, nobody has done that kind of transfer. So therefore he's telling Yogamaya how to do the transfer. It's a very miraculous, mysterious thing, and she learns from Krishna and then she does it. He is telling, Gacha Badram Rajamte, like that, there's one verse. Go to the Vraja, Vrindavan. And then there'll be Rohini. Actually, Balaram has to appear from Rohini's womb. Rohini is the most dear mother of Balaram. But for my sake, on my request, he has come in the womb of Devaki and to make the place ready for me. So you will always see in Yatra also we have advance party. You know that? An advance party will go to any place, make all arrangements. You know, arrange for prasad, arrange for accommodation, put the welcome notices and everything. When the devotees come, everything is ready already. So Balaram is advance party for Krishna. He sends him in advance and he prepares the place. And also he has given order to Yogamaya to transfer him after that, so that he can appear from Rohini. And he says, I'll appear as son of Devaki and you appear as daughter of Yashoda. Like that he's saying. So actually, this Devi is Krishna's sister. Therefore, when he's saying that, although I will appear as son of Devaki and you appear as daughter of Yashoda, I will also appear as son of Yashoda. There are many, many verses in Bhagavatam we can show that Krishna appeared in two places. Because Nandam Atmaja, like that, there's one verse. Atmaja means born in the home of Nanda. That's the meaning, Atmaja. So like that, there are many verses in Bhagavatam. Acharyas like Gopal Champu, our Jiva Goswami, discusses those verses, specific verses which clearly establish Krishna as born in two places. So when Vasudev takes this Krishna, Vasudev Krishna, and goes to Nanda Gokulam, each mystery is beautifully explained. You all may be aware, we will read it in the next chapter. When Krishna appears, all the residents of, all the residents of Mathura were put into sleep. You know that? Why they were put into sleep? So that they could be, Krishna could be conveniently transferred without anybody observing what's happening. Isn't it? And when Krishna entered Nanda Gokulam, there also all of them were sleeping. But these two sleeps are two different type of sleep. In Mathura, the Acharyas have explained that sleep is Mahamaya sleep. Where Nanda Gokulam, the sleep is Yogamaya sleep, it is said. because in the Mathura, the people are all vicious and envious, opposed to Krishna. They are all Kamsa's men. So that sleep is considered Mahamaya sleep. So deep sleep that the watchman was sleeping when Vasudev brought Krishna like this in a basket. They would not, get up if a dog would bite them also. Like that they were asleep. And in Nanda Gokulam also, Yashoda was sleeping in Yogamaya. So that Krishna can... This Krishna was put in her bed. But amazingly, Vasudev did not see one more Krishna there. I just now told you, there was one more Krishna present there, who is called Vrindavan Krishna. So this Vasudev Krishna merged into Vrindavan Krishna. And he took the girl child and took the child to again back to Mathura. So it's amazing, no? Why Vasudev didn't see? Because Vasudev can only see Vasudev Krishna. And Nanda can only see Vrindavan Krishna. And Nanda has never seen 400 form of Krishna. Because that doesn't gel with his bhava. Similarly for Vasudev, the 200 form of Krishna, that doesn't gel with him. Because he is in Aishwarya Bhava with Krishna. And Nanda is in Madhurya Bhava. But Krishna only knows and the Devi only knows that Krishna is appearing in both the places. So when this Krishna... Actually, Vasudev Krishna originally comes ultimately from Vrindavan Krishna only. Therefore, from where he comes, he goes back into that form. Into Vrindavan Krishna. Like when Krishna goes with Akrura and the frontiers of Braja, he tells Akrura, let us stop here for a while. And from the chariot, he goes into Yamuna to take a bath. And when Akrura is thinking, oh, it's getting late. Let me see. So when Akrura is going to Yamuna to see, suddenly he sees Lord in the 400 form in Anantashesh. He gets a darshan. That is the point where the change from Vrindavan Krishna to Vasudev Krishna takes place. That's a transition point. Vrindavanam paritya padamekam nagachati. It is said, Lord doesn't leave Vrindavan at all. That's the meaning of that. Because from there he takes a 400 form and goes to Mathura after that. That's only an expansion of Krishna. Original Krishna is still in Vrindavan with all the devotees. That's the meaning. So now coming back to this order I told you just now. Effects of Lord's appearance in Devaki's home. Prabhu, you can read this.
Yes, Prabhu. 16 to 20. Effects of the Lord's appearance in Devaki's home. Lord enters Vasudeva's mind, illuminated like sun. Then to mind of Devaki, as moon rising in the east. Devaki was like fire covered by pot, or a learned person but unable to benefit society. Devaki illuminated entire place. Kamsa understood that Supreme Personality of Godhead has taken shelter of her womb.
Yeah. So if a lamp is kept in a pot, the lamp is glowing, but it doesn't benefit the room yet because the room is still dark. Similarly, and the child in the womb, child in Devaki's womb was not known to the world who he is for the common people. The people of the world couldn't benefit right now. But the devatas are always aware of the Lord's position. See, devatas have the wisdom to know that Lord is not entangled or bound. Just like if you see this Kantimala, inside the Kantimala there is a nylon thread. Is the nylon thread trapped inside the beads, or are the beads sustained by the nylon thread? The beads are sustained by the nylon thread. Similarly, Lord Krishna may be in the womb of Devaki, but he is actually sustaining the millions of universes. Just like when Yashoda bound Krishna with a rope, he appeared to be bound, but he is never bound. How do you know he is never bound? Can anybody say? Like Yashoda bound Krishna with a rope, but we can say that in one sense he is never bound. Why? A bound person cannot liberate another person. Whereas Krishna is liberating Narakur Manigriv, correct, no? Even in a bound state. Therefore, he is not bound. Only he is bound by love, not bound by anything of this world. Whereas when we are bound in this world, we are bound by something of this world, isn't it? That's the difference. This is a Kamsa's thoughts. Please read it.
Verse 10, 21 to 24, thoughts of Kamsa. She is woman, sister, pregnant. If I kill her,
if I kill her, yeah, then the reputation,
appearance and lifespan will be diminished. I will suffer both in this life and the next, which is hell. And Sukadeva Goswami,
he says that Kamsa then decided to wait.
Kamsa decided to wait.
Yeah.
At all times he thought about the Lord in fear.
Yeah. This is also an important section in this chapter. This is verses 21 to 24. So we can go to this chapter in the Srimad Bhagavatam. See that verse, there's one very important verse about Kamsa's fear, Kamsa Bhayam, Kamsa's fear also. I'll just share that with you. Oh, we are able to see the verses now?
Yes, bro.
Yeah. See, here it uses the word here in this verse number 6. Bhagavan api vishvatma viditva kamsajam bhajam yadunam nidanathanam yogamayam samadishat. He's ordering Yogamaya like this. Please read the translation.
To protect the Yadus, his personal devotees, from Kamsa's attack, the personality of Godhead, Vishwatma, the super soul of everyone, ordered Yogamaya as follows.
He's saying here. See, this is what I told you. Vachya Devi Vajam Bhadre Gopa Gobiralankritam Rohini Vasudevasya Bharyaste Nanda Gokule Anyascha Kamsasam Vigna Vivareshu Vasantihi is telling that Kacha Devi, oh Yogamaya, he Bhadre, oh most auspicious one, Gopa Gopi Alankritam Vrajam Gacha, he's saying. Go to the Vrindavan where Gopas, Gopis, they're constantly remembering me. It's a beautiful place, Nanda Gokulam. Go there. He's saying, and Rohini Vasudevasya Bharyaste. Vasudeva's wife, Rohini, lives there. Why she lives there? Not only Rohini, many others also have fled from Mathura, out of Mathura, due to the fear of Kamsa. So Vasudeva also has kept Rohini there in Nandagokulam, Nandagokule. Not only her, Anyascha Kamsa Samvigna, many other fellows also have left Mathura due to the torments of Kamsa, and they have gone to far away places, like that he is saying. Please go there, he says. Devakya jarre garbham sheshakyam dhamamamakam tatsannikrishya rohinya udare sannivesaya. Yeah. So he says that, you know, my expansion, Shesha, has appeared, you know, so that's what I was explaining to you till now. Huh? And Papa explains the past time, yeah. Yeah. Yeah, this is also I told you. Prapsyami. From Yashodayam, Nanda Patnyam Bhavishyasi, like that he said. Yeah. And then how you will also be born as Yashoda's Putri, they say. Yeah. Yeah. And here one more thing he says, which is not mentioned there. Namadeyani Kurvanti Sanani Cha Narabhuvi Durga Iti. Badrakali iti, Vijaya Vaishnavi iti, cha Kumuda Chandika Krishna Madhavi Kanyaka iti, cha Maya Narayani Ishani Sharada Ambike iti, cha. These are the names, 12 names he says, by which Devi will be called in this world and you will be worshipped. This is a very interesting thing because Krishna says, materialists will worship you, spiritualists will worship me. He's telling her. And we can see with our eyes visibly the world around us. People, those who are eager for accumulating material commodities, they worship Durga and gather them. And actually this can be seen during the Vijayadashami period. Even the materialists who would never do any worship throughout the year in Vijayadashami period, they become very active. Durga Puja and everything. And then he is telling her different names which I read just now. Ambika, Ishani, like that. Chandi, Chamundi, Badrakali, all that. All those names he is telling. So, you will also be worshipped. You will have your devotees, he says. These are the names he says. And Prabhupada says about that. Yeah. Yeah. And then he is telling how Rameti Lokaramanat Balabhadram Balochrayat is saying. Yeah. So he'll be called as Rama and every place the people are Gokulam. Okay. And then it goes here, there is a verse about Kamsa, we will read, I was telling you. See here, please read this translation.
When the child of Devaki was attracted and transferred into the womb of Rohini by Yogamaya, Devaki seemed to have a miscarriage. Thus, all the inhabitants of the palace loudly lamented, "Loss, Devaki has lost her child."
That means everybody is rating child after child. Huh? That's a big subject matter because they know this cruel fellow Kamsa takes the children and kills. He knows that. Huh? Everybody is aware. Yeah. But the child, it was not a miscarriage. It was actually a real carriage. Carrying a child from here to there, which Devi had done. Bhagavan api vishvatma bhaktanam abhayankaraha avivesham shabhagena mana anaka dundubehe. Yeah. Yes, Prabhu.
Thus the Supreme Personality of Godhead, who is the super soul of all the living entities and who vanquishes all the fear of his devotees, entered the mind of Vasudeva in full opulence.
So now this is the one I was telling you. Vasudeva's mind, Lord enters. Yeah. Here he says, here is the Prabhupada says in the purport. The Lord is already there within the mind and consequently it is not astonished for him to appear as if born from a devotee's body. The word avivesha signifies the Lord appeared within the mind of Vasudeva and there was no need for a discharge of semen. That is the opinion of Shripad Sridhara Swami and Shri Ravishankar Chit Thakur. And Sanatana Goswami says that his consciousness was awakened within the mind of Vasudeva. Yeah, and like he says. So, he was very difficult to approach through ordinary sense perception because he was also shining, illuminated, like that. So all even other men like Kamsa and others, he became formidable for them to see. Therefore, it is said, you know, either Lord or the devotee is appearing. Like Prahlad is in the womb. Narada told the Devatas, "Why are you trying to take Kayadu? You will not be able to kill the child in her womb," he said. "If you make an attempt, you will be destroyed." Indra got frightened hearing that. Huh? Because Mahabhagavad devotee, he is constantly protected by the vigil of Lord Vishnu upon him. And the same with Lord Vishnu or Krishna also. When they appear, nobody can actually, you know, kill the Lord. Then he says, therefore he is saying Vasudeva became formidable, he says. Formidable means very, very powerful. Yeah. Yeah. How Devaki became very beautiful, I told you. Huh? Just as east becomes beautiful by carrying the rising moon, he's saying. Huh? See here, he says about Devaki having just been initiated by Vasudeva. Became beautiful by carrying Lord Krishna. Correct, no? This is the point I was telling you. So here Prabhupada says, so we can read this, huh? That's the importance of?
Thus, the importance of initiation is mentioned here. Unless one is initiated by the right person who always carries within his heart the Supreme Personality of Godhead, one cannot acquire the power to carry the Supreme Godhead within the core of one's own heart.
Yeah. The word. See, why the word Achyutamsam is used? Yeah.
The word Achyutamsam is used because the Supreme Personality of Godhead is Shadaishwarya Purna, full in the opulences of wealth, strength, fame, knowledge, beauty, and renunciation.
Yeah. And then he is never separated from his personal opulences, even though he is appearing in this world. Anupapa goes on explaining about this. That Lord is always present in the plenary expansions and everything. And then he goes on. Now, here is what the next verse will come now. A beautiful verse. We'll recite this one. Sa devaki sarva jagan nivasa nivasa bhuta nitaram nareje bhojendra gehegni shikheva ruddha saraswati jnana khale yatasati. See, the third line talks about how the Agni is kept in a pot. How the Saraswati resides in certain poor Brahmanas and the knowledge is not yet benefiting the world. Like that, Krishna was hidden in the womb of Devaki for the time being. Very soon he will manifest. Tam vikshakam saprabhaya jitantaram virochayantim bhavanam shuchismitam ahaishame pranaharoharir guham dhruvam shrito yanna pure yani drushi. With translation?
Because the Supreme Personality of Godhead was within her womb, Devaki illuminated the entire atmosphere in the palace where she was confined. Seeing her jubilant, pure, and smiling, Kamsa thought, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Vishnu, who is now within her, will kill me. Devaki has never before looked so brilliant and jubilant.
Yeah. So you have seen a silvery cloud in the sky. That clearly indicates that there is sun behind. You can't see the sun, but you can say sun is there confidently by seeing the silvery cloud. Like that, Devaki also. Here one very interesting thing about this Iskcon Prabhupada says here. You know, read this one, bro, the Krishna conscious.
The Krishna conscious movement is spreading like wildfire all over the world, and it will go on doing so. Men who are like Kamsa are very much afraid of the movement's progress and acceptance by the younger generation. But as Krishna could not be killed by Kamsa, this movement cannot be checked by the men of Kamsa's class. The movement will go on increasing more and more, provided the leaders of the movement remain firmly Krishna conscious by following the regulative principles and the primary activities of chanting the Hare Krishna mantra regularly.
Isn't it amazing, no? How Prabhupada connects the Devaki and the Krishna, the womb of Devaki to ISKCON. And
the spreading.
And here also Prabhupada, you can read this one also.
One politician has remarked that the Krishna conscious movement is spreading like an epidemic, and that if not checked immediately, within 10 years it may capture the governmental power.
Prabhupada was very, very confident. You can see that. This is what we told, what Kamsa was thinking, correct? No? To kill her, my reputation. You know, he is considering all these things. Kim madhya tasmin karaniyam ashime yadartha tantro navihanti vikramam striyaha swasur guru matya badoyam. In this situation, I should not kill her. She is a woman, she is my sister. Especially she is now pregnant, I should not kill her. Let me wait. When this child is born, then I will finish. Like that he is thinking. People will say that the person is considered very cruel for acting in such a manner. So he considered. One place Prabhupada says, why Kamsa could not kill her? Because, you know, the Lord completely changes the mati only. Because the Lord has to exist. And this is not the time for Kamsa to fight with the Lord when the Lord is in the womb. The Lord molded the head of Kamsa in such a way that he was inclined to not making an assassination attempt now. Like that. Because Lord can do anything. Because he is the matta smitrinyanam apohanam. So correct, no? He can give, in 15:15 Bhagavad Gita says that. He can give the intelligence by which one will act in a certain way. So that type of intelligence the Lord gave to Kamsa. And not to hurt Devaki. Deliberate insight comes a thought of he was determined to continue in enmity. So here you will see Asinaha Sambisha Sambisham Stishthan Bunjana Paryatan Mahim Chintayano Hrishikesham Apashyatan Mayam Jagat. This is an important verse. What he says. Asina, when he is sitting, what all he was doing, you will see. while sitting in the throne on, or in the sitting room, while lying on the bed, or indeed while situated anywhere, while eating, sleeping, walking, Kamsa only saw his enemy, the Supreme God Rishikesha. He was thinking of his all-pervading enemy. Kamsa became unfavorably Krishna conscious. See here, Tishtan, Samvisham, Tishtan, Bunjanaha, Pariyatan, Mahim, Chintayanaha. Always he was thinking. And this is our goal also. While sitting, while sleeping, while getting up, while moving, while walking. Constantly. Only difference is we want to think of Krishna favorably. And he was thinking of Krishna unfavorably. Anukulam pratikul. So, Gopya Kamsat Bayat Kamso. Gopya Gopya Kamat Bayat Kamso. Deshat Chedya Dhyan Pipa. Sambandhat Vrishneha Snehat. So, five types of relationships Narada tells Pandavas. In that, one of them is Bhayat Kamso, he says. Kamsa is Krishna conscious by constant fear of Krishna like this. You know, it is said when his two wives, Asti and Prapti, Jarasandha's daughters, were given to him, in the morning when he would get up from the bed, two wives will come to see him. So, as soon as he would see them, he would shout, "Hey, Krishna Balram!" He would shout. And the wives would say, "Hey, why are you thinking we are Krishna Balram? We are your wives." So that much fear he had. Constantly, anytime they will come and kill me or whatever. Yeah, Prabhupada explains these things. Yeah. So the Goswamis are thinking of Krishna favorably, he says. Yeah. See, here is what it starts, the Bhutashuddhi prayers. Brahma, Shiva, Narada, Devala, Vyasa, Indra, Chandra, Varuna. They all invisibly approached the room of Devaki. Then they all joined in offering their respectful obeisances and prayers. Please, the Supreme God who can bestow blessings upon everybody. Here. So this is the nature of Devatas. They are very, very pious. You know, and Devatas are always there in large pastimes. They will want to praise the Lord. This is the first verse they are offering prayer. If you all can repeat after me. Satyavratam satyaparam trisatyam. Satyasya yonim nihitam cha satye. Satyasya satyam vrata satya netram. Satyatmakam tvam sharanam prapannaha. So it's a very beautiful verse. Satya verse we call it. If you see the translation here, see, Satyavratam means Lord, once he gives a vow, he will never take off from the vow. He will fulfill it. Kunti Maharani says, sun may become cool, moon may become hot, but Krishna will never give up his vrata, she says. And Satyaparam means he is the absolute truth. And Trisatyam means in the past, present, future, he is God always. Similarly, in a Srishti, Sri, Pralaya, in all situations, he is the supreme. He's always present as witness. And then he's saying, Satyasya Satyam, which means of all the relative truths, he is the truth. He is the source of all relative truths. For example, right now I have a table here. Where does the table come from? From a tree. So tree is the cause and table is the effect. And Krishna is the source of cause and effect. Therefore, Nidanam Bijam Abhyayam, Bhagavatam says that. Nidanam means the source of the bijas also. And all the bijas give out all the 8.4 million species. But Lord is the source of the Nidanam, Bijam, Avyayam, he says. So like that he's saying, Satyasya Satyam, he says. Yeah, Satyasya Yonim. He's the source of Yoni of the Satya also. All the relative truths also. And Nihitam Cha Satye. And he has entered into all the elements like earth, water, fire, air, ether, and making them function in this world. And Satyasya Satyam, he accepted as the truth, the truths of all truths. Rita Satya Netram. And the origin of whatever truth is pleasing. One place, the Ritam also is said to be the Vedas. The vision given by the Vedas is also Krishna. Without him, one cannot understand the Vedas. And Satya Atmakam, everything pertaining to the Lord is Satchidananda, saying. And Sharanam Prapannaha. We are all surrendering to you, O Lord. Like that they said. Like this, they will start all the prayers, very, very beautiful prayers. So there are a lot of wonderful purports to this. But it will take time to complete all the purports. See here, this is another interesting verse. Eka yano sau dhivalastri moolash chaturasa panchavidash charatma. There are items given. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like that. Up to 10, the number is counted. Let us see what are they. First he is saying, Ekayanaha, our body in which we all are seated now, is actually it is said one. We all have one body. In that there is dvifalaha. And what are the dvifalaha? Sukha-dukha. Sukha-dukha, mana, apamanshita, ushna. There is duality is there in this body. And three moolaha, what are they? Sattva, rajas, tamas. And chaturasaha, what are they? Dharma, artha, kama, moksha. And pancha vidaha, what are they? The shabda, sparsha, rasa, rupa, gandha. The eyes, ears, nose, tongue and touch sense objects. That is pancha vidaha. And chadatma, what is it? Jara, mrityu, shoka, moha. And kshutipas. That means thirst, hunger, old age, death and illusion and lamentation. That is shadatma. And saptatvak means seven coverings. What are they? Rasa, rakta, madhya, medha, asthipa, you know, shukra and all those things. Skin, blood, muscle, fat, bone, marrow in this body. Ashtavitapaha means eight branches in this bodily tree. What are they? You all know that. Panchamahabhut, earth, water, fire, aritha, and manbuddhi, ahankar. And nava akshaha. What are they? The nine holes in the body. Bhagavad Gita or Krishna calls it as navadware pure dehi. Nakurvanna karyan. Navadware. Every human body, man, woman, animals, birds, everybody has nine holes in the body. Like two eye holes, two nose holes, two ear holes makes it six, and one mouth hole makes it seven, and the urinal and the rectum, that makes it two more, totally nine holes. And dasha chadi means 10 kinds of air. Actually, five are prominent. Prana, pana, dhyana, udana, samana, and five are secondary pranas, secondary airs. Totally 10. And Dikagaha, there are two birds, soul and super soul. And then he says, Adi Vrikshaha. This is the original tree or construction of the material body in which you are situated. And that is what is explained here, if you see. So, now this is a very beautiful analogy which we saw now of the human body compared to a tree with multiple nine holes are in this tree. There are branches in this tree. So, I will revise what we said now. Ekayano means the body. And then Dvifalaha says, what are those two? Who can say what are the two items? The two items are dualities. Sukha, dukkha, mana, apaman, like that. That is Dvifalaha, isn't it? And then three is easy. Three more. Three modes. And Chaturasaha, what is the four ones? Four things? What are the four Purusharthas, four goals?
Dharma, artha, kama, moksha.
Dharma, artha, kama, moksha. And then Pancha, five? You think
five
no, five sense objects. Shabda, sparsha, rasa, rupa, gandha for the senses. Tanmatras you call. And then six? Shadatma, what he said? Six? Let us see, six. Yeah, five senses. Six is said to be, this one, lamentation, illusion, old age, death, hunger and thirst. Six whips. Six are called six whips. Correct, no? Yeah. And the seven, there are seven, beginning from rasa, rakta, madhya, medha, asti, shukra, dasi, seven dhatus in the body, dhatus. Actually, dhatus in the body should be preserved. And mala in the body should be removed. So those are the seven dhatus. And eight, ashta vitapaha, eight branches. That is panchamahabhut and the three, subtle, that is gross and subtle body. That is eight. And nava, what is the nine ones?
Nine gates of the body.
Nine gates of the body, correct. And then ten was dasha chadi.
Ten life airs.
Ten life verse, yeah, correct. So like this, our body is only compared to tree. And in Bhagavatam, there's another place where it is said, imagine somebody is coming and putting fire to this bodily tree, and if a bird is sitting in the tree. Sometimes there is a season called as Patjada, where all the leaves fall completely, and the tree is completely shaven. And the bird is thinking, "Arey, except my nest, there is nothing. I am only sitting here." Suddenly the farmer comes and puts fire to the tree below. That time bird has to fly off immediately. If it is sitting there, it can be in trouble. So similarly, we also Atma seated in this body, bodily tree, with all these 10 items which are said. We should see the body like this tree. And the tree analogy is very perfect, because the tree showers millions of seeds when it is green, hale and healthy, young. And later on, the tree becomes dried up. Similarly, when we are all young in this world, we perform so many karmic activities, and we get karma bandhana by showering those seeds of kama karma bijas, which we carry with us at the time of death to the next body we carry. And each of those seeds will take on the forms of bodies, future material bodies. Fortunately, they have come to Krishna consciousness. Karma and nirdahati, Krishna says. Brahmaji says that all the seeds are going to be burned away when we become serious Krishna conscious devotees. So, the 11th canto, Avadhuta Brahman is saying this, that we are showering the seeds of karmic future, creating like that. Therefore, the tree analogy is very fit. And we are not the tree. We are like the three. It was said in the towards the end, not two people sitting in the tree. One is a which bird? Fruit-eating bird. Another one is a silent bird. So we are the fruit-eating bird. Sometimes we eat a neem fruit and we are finding it bitter. Sometimes we eat a mango fruit and we are enjoying. So we are like, therefore, there are many fruits of the tree. Some are sweet fruits, some are bitter fruits. Sukha-dukha. Isn't it? Sukha-dukha. When we taste the sukha fruit, we are happy. When we taste the dukkha fruit, we are unhappy. Whereas Paramatma is beyond all this. So such a beautiful analogy he gives in this place. Devatas are giving in their talk. So, and it proceeds further from the verse 28. Let's go back to the PPT here. I was thinking of Krishna continuously in his mind. The demigods started the prayer here. They have come to the prison cell and they are starting the prayer. It's a little tiny letter. You all can see clearly?
Yes.
Yeah. See, 26 to 28, Lord is the cause of all causes. And then Lord is the only truth, Satyaparam, Satyavratam, that verse. And then description of the material tree which we read just now. Material bodily tree. Okay? And then the tree arises by your energies. Because you are the one who does creation, maintenance and destruction. Because Lord creates 8.4 million species through the agency of Brahma and Durga. Brahma gives them, supplies the materials, Durga. And Brahma gives a template for the 8.4 million species. So Brahma has a template and she gives materials. When you combine both, then we all get our material bodies. So one jiva you catch and put him in one material body and send him. Go out in the material world and enjoy what you wanted to do. Like that. So in this way, this is a series. After that, the 29 to 31 is the next thing. How Supreme Lord extends His protection to His devotees. And you appear as different incarnations to come to the world to protect your devotees. The lotus feet are the boat to cross over the material world. So there are two types of protection. While living in the material world, Lord gives protection to you to practice your bhakti, even in the midst of demoniac forces. Even though they are demoniac forces. And then after you complete the term of your sadhana bhakti, Lord's lotus feet becomes a boat to cross over the material world and through the Mahajanas, they have left behind the boat for us, all their practices and all. Using that, we can go back to Godhead. So both ways, Lord's protection is there. And then you accept the method given by the Acharyas as a process to cross the material world, which means like, for example, Prabhupada said, chant 16 rounds, follow 4 regs, I can assure you, we'll come back to Godhead. And Lord Krishna also accepts. My devotee has made the 16 rounds understanding the situation of Kali Yuga, no problem. I accept it. Lord is agreeable to pure devotees, reducing the standard a little bit. Lord says, my pure devotees love me so much. For their sake, I'm ready to bend. Lord also is willing to bend. Then who can access the Lord's protection? Only His devotees. Jnanis can't access, but devotees can. Even if devotees fall down from the path, again they will get up immediately and walk ahead. Navayjano jato katanchana vraje mukundasevyan javadanga samsutim paran mukundangri upagohanam punar vihadam icche narasagraho janaha. That verse says, because devotee has tasted a few droplets of honey from Krishna's lotus feet, even though they fall down, they will come back again, he says. And what inspires devotion in this world? First, you create good fortune by teaching the Vedas through Brahma, through the Guru Parampara. And only by your transcendental presence can, that only can influence devotees to understand your transcendence. Because if you don't give your mercy, merciful glance on us, you can't understand the Vedas on our own. And nana amarupe guna janma karma vyadhirupitavye tavasasya sakshinaha mano vachobhyamanumeya vartmano deva kriyayam pradiyantitapi. Deva kriyayam means only by devotional service. One can understand your name, form and attributes. Otherwise by our own speculation you can't understand, like they are saying. And by engaging in shravanam, kirtanam, smaranam, your deva kriyayam is done. Devotional service is done. And then why does... what the purpose of appearing in this particular time? To remove the burden of that which is kamsa now. And you appear, also you want to appear for your own pleasure to exchange love with your devotees. Since you appeared, please protect us like you did in the previous incarnations. Now also protect us from kamsa, they're saying. And the devatas glorified Devaki also. So if you see these prayers, they are all put in one line. One theme. First one is Lord is the cause of all causes. He is the only true description of material coming from Him. CMD, construction, maintenance, creation, maintenance, destruction, He does. So they are all one particular theme. Similarly, how Lord protects His devotees, that is second theme. And who can access the Lord, that is third theme. Jnanis cannot, but Bhaktas can. And what inspires devotion in the heart of the devotees, that is the next theme. And why does the Lord appear in this particular time? That is the next theme. So these are five themes are there in this. This way. And then now it gets into the prayer, you know, what we discussed. So I will send you across this small document file. So in the document file, which I'll just show you the document file. So if the prayers and the texts are given there, you will be able to get a bird's eye view by seeing this. Like see, demigods offering prayers. Actually, these prayers are also very wonderful. They're very, very important prayers. Here only it comes, this verse, where they say, Jnanis fall down, isn't it? So like this, many, many important verses will come in this. So I have made some notes. I will just share this with Rajaka Prabhupada, we can send you all. Okay? So I'll conclude with this. So some important points are given in the notes. You can go through that. And that if you are going to go verse by verse along with purports, then we will need many hours to discuss this chapter. Now we got an idea. So in today's session, what I did was, I spent some time to explain about the nature of Krishna's appearance and the difference in the appearance of the conditioned soul's appearance. You know, birth in this world, that we took some time. Then I told about the demigods offering prayers to Lord in the Kamsa's nature and the devatas and also about disciples' initiation. So such kinds of things we discussed, which is a background for this chapter, which is also very important. They are also very important, this kind of thing. And generally I do this in two sittings. One sitting I do this, and the second sitting we get into the prayer deeply. But if we do that next time, then Janmashtami will be missed, I feel, isn't it? So we have one lecture before Janmashtami, I think.
Yes, bro. One more lecture.
Correct. Next month. Is it second week? Let me just see. In August, for me it's 9th August early morning. For you it will be 8th August, I think. Sunday. Correct, Prabhu?
Yes, bro.
Yeah. So I was thinking of doing Dharmashtami lecture on that day because the next chapter is very interesting. Krishna's advent is a beautiful chapter it is. There are select restrictions I will do from that. All right? And this you all can read it yourself. I will pass the notes to you. Okay?
Thank you so much, Prabhu.
Thank you. Jayashri Prabhupada ki. Gaur Bhaktavinda ki.
Will you be able to take a question from me?